الذين آمنوا وتطمئن قلوبهم بذكر الله، ألا بذكر الله تطمئن القلوب.
أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Welcome dear brother, dear sisters. إن شاء الله we're still in our journey with the blessed Holy Quran, with the best of the speeches, the words, the word of Allah, the Holy Quran, the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inshallah, this second episode from the chapter of the thunder, Surah Al-Ra'd, will cover tonight verse number 3 and 4, inshallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Almighty said, وَهُوَ الَّذِي مَدَّ الْأَرْضَ وَجَعَلَ فِيهَا رَوَاسِيَ وَأَنْهَارًا وَمِنْ كُلِّ الثَّمَرَاتِ جَعَلَ فِيهَا زَوْجَيْنِ اثْنَيْنِ يغشي الليل النهار، يغشي الليل النهار، إن في ذلك لآيات لقوم يتفكرون. Let's see the meaning of this ayah from Nur al-Bayan, and we'll go with more details to understand how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is covering, showering us 24/7 with His ni'am, bounties and favors, subhanahu almighty, azza wa jal. Allah is the one whom spread out the earth for your living and placed in it mountains that are fixed. He made the rivers flow on earth so you can drink and benefit from them. He has created in pairs every kind of fruit, black, white, sweet, and sour. He created the night to cover the day with its darkness. Indeed, in it there are signs, ayat, for those whom reflect. يبقى دي ايات ايه؟ كونيه. Remember when I was explaining the types of ayat, ayat al-Quran versus ayat with the prophets and messengers, the miracles, and الايات الكونيه. This ayah is talking about الايات الكونيه. Ayuh, the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in His universe, like the creation of the heaven, the earth, the oceans, and all of this. In it, there are signs for those whom reflect. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's sending this ayat one after another to tell us and to let us know His ayat, signs. What did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala do? He said, مَدَّ الْأَرْضَ. He spread out the earth for you. For your living, subhanahu wa ta'ala. فالأرض, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spread it out. It's in front of all of us, subhanallah. There is no limit for it. And الأرض مكورة. It's like ostrich egg, subhanallah. والأرض بعد ذلك دحاها. الدح means the بيضة, an egg. فthe scholar, they said the shape of it, it is not مسطحة, flat, no. Flat means مسطحة, means there is an end for it. Start and the subhanallah, beginning and the end of it. But الأرض مكورة, مكورة. والأرض بعد ذلك, Quran said that, دحاها, أخرج منها ماءها ومرعاها والجبال أرساها متاعا لكم ولأنعامكم. فالأرض, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spread it out. It's a very big and wide. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's talking to those who've been oppressed in certain place on His earth, and they said, Ya Rabb, we have an excuse that we've been oppressed. That's why we're not able to worship You in our land, in our area, wherever. Allah said, أَلَمْ تَكُنْ أَرْضُ اللَّهِ وَاسِعَةً فَتُهَجِّرُوا فِيهَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, is it my earth or my land? It's not big and wide, and they spread it out for you, and you can migrate. If you will be oppressed in certain place, you can migrate to another place. This is what happened to the Sahaba. They migrated twice from Mecca to Abyssinia. Then Rasulullah himself, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with the Sahaba, they migrated from Mecca to Medina. Yes, because even Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when they drove him out from Mecca, he went to Taif. He did not just sit and they say, khalas, that's it. No, we have to understand that. But the problem is, nowadays, especially because of the politics, because of kada, too many things, people, they are putting borders on the land now. This country so and so, and this country so and so. And all of it, the land of Allah. I remember when we came to America, one of the sheikhs was telling me, why you're going to America? It's the Dar al-Kufr. And it's talking like the way of Abu Jahl. يعني. It's the Dar al-Kufr. And you're going to the Al-Khamr, Al-Khanzir, Al-Zina, and I don't know. We're not coming for Al-Khamr, Al-Khanzir, Al-Zina. It's the land of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he spread it out for us to live in it. Either in America or Egypt or in Afghanistan or Pakistan or Bangladesh. So or the land of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The main thing is your heart. The main thing in your what's in your heart, your iman and your deen. الأرض لكل الناس. Allah did create this earth for all الأنام. والأرض سورة الرحمن والأرض وضعها للأنام. Allah made it for الأنام, for the jinn and the ins, for everybody. The way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raised up the sky and the heavens, He made this earth for us and He spread it for us to live in it. الأرض is moving very fast. متحركة. الأرض is not firm just to be ثابتة to stop like this. No. الأرض is a planet. And it's moving around itself and around the sun and the moon. وليس ثابت. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He spread the earth for us and the earth is moving, the earth was not balanced. It was not balanced. طيب, what did Allah do? He created on it what? The mountains. This is what He said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَجَعَلَ فِيهَا رَوَاسِيَ And وَجَعَلَ فِيهَا رَوَاسِيَ And He placed in it mountains that are fixed. وَالْجِبَالَ أَوْتَادًا سبحان الله. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the earth, it was moving, not balanced. And what Allah did, Allah created the mountains and He placed it and fixed it in it and being balanced. Because the earth is moving so fast, subhanallah. طيب, maybe somebody gonna tell me, Sheikh, people nowadays, they are taking from the mountains, they are destroying the mountains with the machines and they are taking granite, they're taking tiles, they are taking too many minerals or some stuff from the mountains, you know, and it, subhanallah, that's from place to place, that will make the earth like unbalanced. I will tell you something, wait a minute. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's the creator, Almighty Azza wa Jal. He knows what He did. The earth, it is like the watermelon. From outside has the thick al-qishra. It's very thick and solid, the watermelon. But more you go to the center of the watermelon, more it's what? في الياف وفي water وفي sweet things. It's the earth exactly the same like this. Inside the earth, more you go into the earth close to the center, you're going to see what? Himam, volcanoes. You're going to see, subhanAllah, a lot of things inside. And more you go into the core of the core of the earth, which is in Nawah, it's a multahiba, it's fire inside. Himam. It's himam, ya Mawlana. Isha ya Mawlana. Isha ya Am Khanzab. Himam, subhanAllah. So that's why the earth from inside, it's liquid. It's what? Mostly liquid inside. Why liquid? Aywa. And it's moving, right? With its speed, it's moving. If the earth is same like a dog, like same piece, all these towers on above the earth will fall down, will be destroyed. Especially people now, they're taking part of this mountain and they move it to another place on earth, means that the balance will not be equal. How this balance, the earth is still balanced now while people moving these mountains, destroying mountains from place to place and taking part of this mountain and that mountain on earth. SubhanAllah, they're using for too many things. Because of that liquid inside, if the earth became unbalanced from the surface, like because of the mountain or something, SubhanAllah, that water or liquid inside is going from place to place according to the heaviness or the mountains where is light, where is heavy from the above the earth. SubhanAllah, that's why the liquid balances the earth inside the في بطن in the core of the earth. Allah created like that. فسبحانallah, we have to know that Allah is capable and He knows what He's doing, subhanahu wa ta'ala. بسبب السائل الداخلي الأرض بإيه بتكون متوازنة. Outside the earth it's a very solid like the cover or the green cover of the watermelon, القشرة from outside. سبحانallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this out of mercy, He made inside the earth is liquid, subhanAllah.
فالسائل اللي في بطن الأرض بينتقل من مكان إلى إيه؟ إلى مكان. The same thing your brain. Your brain is swimming around the water. Otherwise, that brain is going to be very heavy. You cannot carry it. If you move your head like this, the water is carrying the brain, and your brain is moving with the liquid around it, subhanAllah, to cover it and to protect it and to, subhanAllah, to make it light for you. And above the earth, it's thiqal. It's everything, the towers, the mountains, whatever. Why? To balance the earth like what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala he created, subhanahu wa ta'ala. ففي تعادل, في justice, في balance, like what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, he placed the mountains that to balance the earth and they are fixed. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala azza wa jal said in the Holy Quran, from this mountains you can get a lot of benefits. For example, you see like country like Saudi Arabia. Saudi Arabia, it's all desert, الربع الخالي, it's خالي, empty. There is nothing in Saudi Arabia, just mountains and the and for certain time, Saudi people, they did not find even some water to drink, right? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from amongst this desert and these mountains there, he get what for them? The oil, the gas, the oil and everything. And this is what, from what? Under the mountains and under the sea. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from this oil, you can get your food, you can get your stuff because of that, see? And you see a country like Egypt, we have the Nile River there and people, they are planting, they get vegetation and stuff, but we don't have oil like Saudi Arabia. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is balancing everything on earth, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And look what he said, Surah Fussilat, verse number 10. قُلْ أَإِنَّكُمْ لَتَكْفُرُونَ بِالَّذِي خَلَقَ الْأَرْضَ فِي يَوْمَيْنِ. Are you denying Allah, the one who has created the earth in 2 days? وَتَجْعَلُونَ لَهُ أَنْدَادًا. And you have co-partners with him, worship with him, with Allah. ذلك رب العالمين. He is the Lord of the whole mankind, jinn and ins. وجعل فيها رواسي من فوقها. Above the earth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala placed mountains. It's fixed. وبارك فيها. And Allah blessed it. Allah put his blessings on earth. وقدر فيها أقواتها في أربعة أيام سواء للسائلين. And Allah created in 2 days, another 2 days he placed the mountains and he put the barakah and the provision and the rizq equal all 4 days, subhanAllah. And he created the heavens in 2 days also, it's equal all to 6 days. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed the mountains, and the mountains, it's part of the earth, part of the earth. And subhanAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he put the arzaq, the provision of people into the mountains and the earth too. And subhanAllah, and also imagine that if the mountains are like just dirt or dust. يعني these mountains after a while, because of the rain, gonna be nothing, gonna be just like mud and that's it. But Allah make it solid. The rain take little bit from the surface of it and the mountains are solid, subhanAllah. وَجَعَلَ فِيهَا رَوَاسِيَ وَأَنْهَارَ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he made on this earth the rawasi, like the mountains, and the rivers flow on earth, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the provision of the people comes from these mountains and comes from what? From the rivers and the water. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said rawasiya wa anhar. What is rawasi? Mountains, it's very solid. Anhar, it's liquid, right? And inside this anhar, the liquid, which is the rivers, he said, in Nahr, it is different from al-Bahr. In Nahr, the river, which is its water, is sweet. You can use it. You can give it to the plant, the vegetations, and the seeds, and you give that sweet water to bring these vegetations and the fruits for you. And you can drink it, use it. And also, another type of water, which is a solid water, salty water, the salty water. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring the mutadaddat. All of them, they are opposite to each other. Salty and sweet and mountains and the liquid, subhanallah. And out of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out of his mercy, look at this, out of Allah's mercy, jama'ah, he made the water of the rivers above level, above the water of the ocean. If the opposite, then we're going to be in big problem. That's why you see, for example, I was in that area, in area called Dumyat in Egypt, اللي هي بسموها رأس البر. Ras al-Bahr area, in the in the close to Bursaid and Alexandria in the Mediterranean Sea. That area, subhanallah, you know, the Nile River, its distance from Abyssinia to Egypt more than 6,000 kilometers. That water is going inside the Nile River by Allah's order, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah the one who brought this Nile River. Nobody dig it. It's since Allah created the earth and that water is running. And they gave and providing for all of these countries around it. The ended where? In Egypt. That's why we say Egypt, Hibat al-Nil. Without the Nil, the Nile, Egypt will die. Yeah. And the people, they live around the water in Egypt. In less than 60% of the land of Egypt. Egypt is big land. We live around like the water, just 60%. Where is the Nile River? Subhanallah. So that's why, if you look there, I've been there before 2 years, subhanallah. Me and Sheikh Ibrahim, we've been there. And I see that's called the area, they call the Tongue Lisan, I know. The Tongue Lisan. What? The end of the Nile River water is going to the Mediterranean Sea. And the Nile River water is higher than the Mediterranean Sea. Imagine if the Mediterranean Sea higher than the Nile River water. What can happen? The water of the salt water will go into the river. It means we will not have any sweet water to drink. For any rivers, Bihar, no, I'm sorry, Anhar, rivers, Anhar in the world higher than the oceans. البحر. And the ocean, البحر, it's a salty water. And if the water of Tatgha and the water of the ocean will go into the water of the rivers, people will not find water to drink. But Allah, the one who created, subhanallah. And you see the ayah in Surah Al-Rahman, مرج البحرين يلتقيان بينهما برزخ. بينهما برزخ لا يبغيان. What is a barzakh? It's a barrier between the sweet water and the salty water. And you can see it in this area, in Ras al-Bahr in Egypt, in the Miyat. Yes, subhanAllah, when you see the water of the Nile River is going into the water of the Mediterranean Sea, you're going to see, subhanAllah, that barzakh barrier between this water and that water, and it's not mixed. SubhanAllah. And this is salty water on the side, and this is sweet water on another side. Allah mentioned it already in the Holy Quran. So it's a miracle from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But we can learn in the mayit al-anhar a'la min mayit al-bahar fi al-ard kullah, the whole entire earth. That's why, subhanallah, the mayit al-anhar, the water of the rivers, sweet water is going into the oceans, the salt water. If the opposite, we're going to be in big trouble, all of us. We cannot find any sweet water to drink or to use it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who said that. And he said, وَجَعَلَ فِيهَا رَوَاسِيَ وَأَنْهَارًا وَمِنْ كُلِّ الثَّمَرَاتِ جَعَلَ فِيهَا زَوْجَيْنِ اثْنَيْنِ يُغْشِ اللَّيْلَ النَّهَارِ. He has created, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he said, so you can drink and benefit from that sweet water. He has created in pairs every kind of fruits. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, كُلِّ الثَّمَرَاتِ. Allah made pairs, subhanallah, from these fruits. يُغْشِ اللَّيْلَ, and he said these pairs could be black, white, or sweet and sour. Subhanallah. And Allah created night to cover the day with its darkness. Indeed, there are too many signs for those whom reflect. We learn that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created everything in pairs. Even the animals, even the everything, he said everything in pairs. Everything. That's why Nuh alayhi salam, when he was going to the ark, he used to take pairs of everything, of the animals and everything. زوجين كل زوجين زوجين يعني two similar things يعني for example your shoes it's pairs right anything يعني كل زوجين both similar it's called زوجين you know these pairs okay even the electricity they found it maybe somebody gonna say the electricity oh where is the pairs they found it in the electricity minus and plus or سالب وموجب right if both of them they are not put minus and minus or plus and plus is not working. You have to put minus and this is going to work. Even with the electricity. If somebody is going to tell you the Quran is wrong, Allah said, min kulli shay, everything bears. From everything Allah did create, this bears, subhanahu wa ta'ala. White, black, dark, kaza, and sweet, sour, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, azza wa jal. And he made it bears, why? For the takathur to... سبحان عبد الله سيد سورة ياسين فيرس نمبر 36 سبحان الذي خلق الأزواج كلها الله purified himself عز وجل the one who created the pairs مما تنبت الأرض from the vegetations ومن أنفسهم and as a human also male and females ومما لا يعلمون and things you are not aware about it. الله أكبر. We're not aware about too many things in this life. Even the names of Allah, we don't know all of them. Subhanallah. That's why القرآن الكريم الله سبحانه وتعالى said القرآن before the knowledge of you. And more you discover things, more القرآن will talk about it later and you're going to understand it later. Allah said سبحانه الذي خلق الأزواج كلها. Allah the one who created all pairs. Subhanallah wa ta'ala. يغشي الليل النهار. أيوة. تأتي الظلمة على النهار فتغطي. يغشي الليل النهار. He created the night to cover the day with its darkness. سبحانه وتعالى. يبقى الظلمة تأتي على النهار فتغطي. Darkness covering the day. And Allah سبحانه وتعالى said in Surah Al-Isra, verse number 12. فمحونا آية الليل وجعلنا آية النهار مبصرة. And the night covered the day. The day covered the night. That's called the alternation of the day and night. Who did this? Allah. وهو الذي جعل الليل والنهار خلفة. خلفة يعني إيه؟ خلفة يعني one comes after another. Or خلفة, the time of the day is different from the time of the night. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there's a meaning. Some tafsir too. يبقى the time of the day is completely different. خلفة means مختلف, different. And خلفة means alternation. اللي هو اللي one comes after another. This is the meaning of the ayah also. سبحانه وتعالى. If I ask you a question, very important. هل الليل هو الذي خلق أولا أم النهار؟ Which one of Yasamura Allah did create first? The day or the night?
The day.
Wrong. Wrong. Both are wrong. Wake up, guys. Arab people, they used to think before the night being created before the day. Why? Because they used to consider the months from the appearance of the moon. And they said the night of the day. يعني this is the night of tomorrow. And how can you know Ramadan is tomorrow or the days of Al-Hajj? From the sight of the sighting of the moon. That's why Arab people, they used to think like that. When the night comes before its day, which is tomorrow. But Allah said something different in the Quran. Both, since Allah created them both, they are coming together. They are together. There is no night before the day and the day before night. I will give you the dalil. And tomorrow, or look now, in Middle East, what is in Middle East now? What is in Egypt and Saudi Arabia and Qatar? There is a day there and the night here, right? Means it is according to the movement of the sun. If the sun will be shown to a certain country, this is a day. Sun will disappear from that country, means the night comes. Means they are together. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we used to think that night comes before the day. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, look what Allah said in Surah Yasin, verse number 40. للشمس ينبغي لها أن تدرك القمر. The sun will never gonna reach the moon. Each one of them has distance and each one of them running or swimming or running in its orbit. Okay? وكل في فلك. بس before I forget the part. ولا الليل سابق النهار. I got it now. The night never comes before the day. ولا الليل سابق النهار means you're wrong. If you're telling me the night comes before the day, you're wrong. Both are together. Now we are in America. Night in Middle East, in Egypt or Qatar or Saudi Arabia, it's a day, right? Subhanallah, even in India too, right? In Bangladesh too, yeah. It's a day there, see? Yeah, so I'm telling you, both are together. The sun is disappearing from there, it's somewhere else in the half of the earth. The earth that disappeared there, it comes here. Means the day and the night. Allah, since Allah created them, they are coming together. The night is not coming before the day. Allah said, وَلَا اللَّيْلُ سَابِقُ النَّهَارِ. The night never comes before the day. See? Now we can understand. After I finish. وَلَا اللَّيْلُ سَابِقُ النَّهَارِ. وَكُلُّمْ فِي فَلَكٍ يَسْبَحُونَ. Allah said, إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِقَوْمٍ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. In this, what Allah is showing you, the earth, the mountains, the rivers, and the fruits, and all of that, the day and the night, ayat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, in it, there are signs for those whom reflect. لِقَوْمٍ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. To reflect, brothers, it's your responsibility. And if you never reflect and think, you're like, I'm sorry, like animals. You are eating, drinking, going to the bathroom, making sex, that's it. This is your life. You eat, you go to the bathroom, you make intercourse, like animals. But animals, they live the way Allah created them. the way Allah like machines, animals like that, but you are different. Allah created you and gave you brain, mind, think, reflect. Allah said in the Quran, لَقَوْمٍ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. In this ayat, and your tafakkur, reflection, or thinking, it's your responsibility. Otherwise, if you did not think about عالم الملك, whatever you can see, Allah will never gonna guide you to عالم الملكوت, whatever is hidden from you. Yes, this is what Allah said. And when you think and you reflect through the Quran or anything around you, the universe, it's a book مفتوح, open book for you. Like the Quran, it's a book. The Quran is guiding you to the universe and the universe is guiding you to the Quran. Both from Allah Azza wa Jal. There is no contradiction. And you're going to reach the level of al-haqiqah. You're going to be certain about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Verse number 4, we'll finish with it inshallah very fast. وَفِي الْأَرْضِ قِطَعٌ مُتَجَاوِرَاتٌ وَجَنَّاتٌ مِّنْ أَعْنَابٌ وَزَرْعٌ وَنَخِيلٌ صِنْوَانٌ وَغَيْرُ صِنْوَانٍ يُسْقَى بِمَاءٍ وَاحِدٍ وَنُفَضِّلُ بَعْضَهَا عَلَى بَعْضٍ فِي الْأُكُلِ إن في ذلك لآيات لقوم يعقلون. إن في ذلك لآيات لقوم إيه؟ يعقلون. طيب. Let's see the meaning of this ayah. Inshallah we'll make come after that. In the earth, again, Allah is talking about why the earth? Because you live in it. And you have to know what Allah did create for you. To know His azama, His greatness, and to tell Him, thank you, Allah. Allah did not just create this earth for you just to sleep and that's it. You're gonna die. Allah create you from it and you're gonna go back to it. And you see what Allah created in it for your benefit. He raised the sky for you, the heavens. Create the mountains, the oceans, and too many things to get the benefits, your risk, your provision in it. And everything Allah, as I explained just right now. See the meaning of this ayah number 4. In the earth, there are adjacent pieces of land very close together. قِطْعَ الْمُتَجَاوِرَاتِ And gardens of grapes, aywa, jannat min a'nab, farms, and date palms, trees with single or double trunk. Although the same water irrigates all, la ilaha illallah. We make some of them better than others in the taste, la ilaha illallah. Same tree. Nowadays, بعملوا حاجة بالتقليم, the same trunk of the tree, they can put too many different types of fruits. And the same water, same land, and you eat lemon, sour, and you eat something sweet beside it. A teen or fig or some. Who did this? Allah Azza wa Jal. Who did this for you? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All of these are signs from Allah, as I told you. Whatever Allah did create, the sun, the moon, the mountains, the oceans, and everything. This one of the ayat Allah. Ayat Allah means the signs, al-ayat al-kawniyya, in the kawn, the universe of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All of these are signs from Allah for those people whom use their common sense, يعقلون, and understand. Those who have common sense, those who are عاقل, they have brain, not insane people. They are using their mind to think about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This ayah comes with more details about this verse number 105 in Surah Yusuf. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the end of Surah Yusuf, وَكَأَيِّن مِنْ آيَةٍ فِي السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ Any signs in the heaven and the earth, يَمُرُّونَ عَلَيْهَا وَهُمْ عَنْهَا مُعْرِضُونَ They are passing by it, but they are neglecting it. They are away from it. Subhanallah, they never think about it. طيب. This ayah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَهُوَ الَّذِي مَدَّ الْأَرْضَ وَجَعَلَ فِيهَا رَوَاسِ Allah, the one who spread out the earth for you, and He created the mountains and placed it in it to fix it, and being fixed it. وأنهار rivers flow ومن كل الثمرات from each and every fruits white, black, sour and all of sweet جعل فيها زوجين he create bears for you of everything يغشي الليل النهار and the night covers the day I explain this ayah and the معنى القطع المتجاورات on the earth سبحان الله all of this earth it is not like a doll same piece if you see the doll same piece but the earth is different completely The earth has different portions. That's why you see part of the earth white, black, red, and you see the mountains. وَمِنَ الْجِبَالِ غَرَابِيبٌ سُودٌ وَحُمْرٌ وَبِيضٌ وَسُودٌ SubhanAllah, from the mountains. You see some mountains red, some mountains black, some mountains white mountains. And the earth like this. Even the people too, because we've been created from the earth as a mora, a khanzab. You see some khanzab, سب خنزب بين كرياتي فرموات سبحان الله لك بلاك بلاك شيب. أنا متعمت أعمل ريكوردينج جيسك بقى. Let me finish. Okay. You see, people are different even in our skin because we've been created from the earth. من أحمرها, from its red and white and black and dark. And people even different like this. For the earth is not مستطرقة. مستطرقة like one piece, like a dough, like العجينة. No. فالله سبحانه وتعالى, he made that kind of solid, سبحان الله. It's a good valid for certain piece of fruits or vegetations on the plant. It's different. Even the weather is different too. Subhanallah. That's why Allah created all of this. You see some places, they are planting wheat there. They are planting moose, banana there. Too many there. They're like, banana is good for this weather, for this land. Some of them planting like figs or planting the different fruits. Subhanallah. Some of it's good for corn. It's not good for rice, for example. In India and Egypt, they plant rice or cotton, for example. Uh-huh. Different places, like subhanallah, different for that. Even the turba, the ground itself, subhanallah. فالأرض is not مستطرقة. It is not one piece like the dough. Subhanallah. فالله created like this. Even the fruits. You see that palm tree, the trunk, drinking from the same water, same land. But subhanAllah, even the dates is different. Look is different, size is different. And subhanAllah, everything is different. One tree, one trunk. And they put this fig here. They put banana, whatever. This is a new thing for the planting the trees nowadays. Everything, you know. And they have a lot of things, you know. SubhanAllah. That's why nowadays you see watermelon has no seeds, right? Watermelon inside, yellow. We know the watermelon, it's red inside. It's yellow now. And the outside is different color. They are working with the gene and all of this stuff. SubhanAllah. See, who made this? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who give them this knowledge? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why even the ground, the earth, the salt, it's red, black, dark, sand, and all of this is different, subhanAllah. And they are close to each other. So who created this? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they said, وَجَنَّاتٍ مِنْ أَعْنَابٍ وَزُرُوعٍ وَنَخِيلٍ صِنْوَانٍ وَغَيْرَ صِنْوَانٍ. Let's see the ayah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, عز وجل, he said, gardens of grapes, farms, and date palm trees with single or double trunk, although the same water irrigates all, we make some of them bitter than others in taste. All of these are the signs from Allah for those people who use their common sense and understand. Subhanallah. And they said, الصنوان. What is الصنوان? قال صلى الله عليه وسلم في الحديث, العمو صنو أبيك. يعني صنو. Your عم, your uncle, he's similar to your dad. Even in Egypt, we never say عمي. We say أبويا. When we talk about العم, الأب means the father. يقول لك أبويا فلان, أبويا so and so, أبويا means the أب, my أبي يعني. We never say uncle or عمي in Egypt. We say أبويا. That's why الشيخ شعراوي, he said, according to this, may Allah forgive him, يعني, this is اجتهاد, I disagree with him. He said, the father, well, I'm adopting his tafsir in English, that's tafsir الشيخ شعراوي mostly. But not everything I agree with him, يعني. He was a big scholar, يعني, طبعا, of course. But he said, the father of Prophet Ibrahim Azar, he's not his real father. He was his uncle. Because we say in Egypt, عمي. عمي means أبويا, يعني. And Rasulullah said in the hadith, العمو صن وأبيك. العمو صن وأبيك, your uncle is like your similar, صن means similar to your dad. This is exactly the hadith said. يعني مثل, similar to your dad. We see one tree, like what I just said, and that tree with the same water, subhanAllah, and but its fruits different completely. And this is a jama'ah in Jannah, inshallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Baqarah, لو بشر الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات أن لهم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار كلما رزقوا منها من ثمرة رزقا قالوا هذا الذي رزقنا من قبل وأتوا به متشابها ولهم فيها أزواج مطهرة وهم فيها خالدون يا راجل وهم فيها خالدون. أيوة. فسبحان الله, in Jannah the mu'min will go to that same tree, for example apple tree there or banana or orange, any three fruits there. And they're going to say, I ate from this today. Oof, I get tired. And he will go there close the same fruit he was eating before. He's going to look at it. It's different taste, different size, different shape, completely different. With from the same tree in Jannah, nothing similar there. Subhanallah. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us the earth here. Part of Jannah, ya jama'ah. Allah said, wa baraka fiha. Allah blessed it here. You see different taste, different kada, different. From the same tree, Allah is telling you in Jannah bitter. Bitter in Jannah for you. For Allah capable, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And these are the signs for those who are understanding. Those who have logic, they can understand. Subhanallah. And Allah said, وَنُفَضُّلُ بَعْضَهَا عَلَى بَعْضٍ فِي الْأُكُلِ. And we have something better than others. We love it, subhanallah. يعني, see, for example, when you go to the market and you try to get some fruits, you see too many fruits in the market, right? Sometimes you see the seller is putting this fruit, the same dates, but this is with like $5, another one with $50. Same dates. But why you say that? Look at it. Look at it. Are you organic? Could be organic. The shape is different, shining, clean. You look at it, your eyes will go there. It's the dates, but the quality is different. It's same dates. Maybe from the same tree, but the quality is different. That's why you pay here 50, you pay 5 there. Subhanallah, it is the same. Allah said, وَنُفَضُّلُ بَعْضَهَا عَلَى بَعْضٍ فِي الْأُكُلِ. The taste is different. The color is different. From the same tree, who created? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. الأصل واحد. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, these are the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to somebody has logic, can understand, and he understand the order of Allah, his amr Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his command, and whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbids. That's why Allah is capable, ya jama'ah. Huwa azza wa jal, one God, ilahun yu'bad, we have to worship him, he deserve it, and he show you his capability, and we are all in need to him around you in his dominion. This is called alam al-mulk. Alam al-the world of al-mulk, whatever your eyes can see. More you think, more you reflect, Allah will guide you to alam al-malakut. Alam al-malakut, whatever is hidden from you. Asking Allah to guide us all, inshallah. We'll continue, inshallah, later. Jazakum Allah khairan.